Hi, Aryan here at Game Dev Box. This video is all about warming up shaders in both old and modern graphics APIs to improve your gameplay performance and reduce stuttering during gameplay. Let us start with the old graphics APIs. When I say old graphics APIs, I mean everything other than DirectX 12, which is a bit different to setup. The easiest way to do this is to open your Game Manager script or any script responsible for loading your level and simply add a shader.warmupAllShaders. This will warm up all the shaders in your project when the level loads. This might sound cool, but it's almost completely useless. Why? Because 99% of the time you will have a lot of shaders and warming them all up can easily crash your game, take up too much memory, or simply take forever. For example, if I try to play my game after doing this, you will see that Unity crashes. That's because my memory runs out and So let's forget about warming up all shaders and instead focus on warming up only the ones we need. To do this, you can create a shader variant collection, go to create, then shader, and select shader variant collection. Give it a name, and here you can add the specific shaders you want to include in the collection. If you're wondering which shaders your game uses at runtime, there are two approaches. Go to graphics settings and enable log shader compilation. Then in the build settings, enable development build and build your project. After playing the game, check the player log to see which shaders are being used. A simpler way is to go to graphics settings and at the bottom of the shader section, there is a button to save the tracked shaders of your scene to a collection. You can also clear the current tracked shaders, play your game, and then resave the collection after playing. It might take some time, but it will track all the shaders used during gameplay. Once done, save the collection assets in your desired folder. And now you have a list of shaders your game is using. But do you need to warm up all of these shaders? Absolutely not. Even with this filtered list, there are still too many variants, and warming them all up might take too much time or resources. My advice is to focus on the shaders that are used frequently or cause noticeable stuttering during runtime. For example, I prioritize warming up my vegetation shaders because my train heavily uses vegetation assets. To warm up this shader collection, you have two options. Go to graphics settings and add the preload shaders option. Then add your shader collection here. However, keep in mind this will load the shaders at the very start of your game. Alternatively, get a reference to the shader variant collection in your script and call the warmup function at the start of your game. And that's it. Now my game runs more smoothly and I'm confident that shader stuttering won't happen due to FPS spikes or other issues. This approach works well for most graphics APIs, but DirectX 12 is a little different. DirectX 12 uses graphics estates, so capturing the shader requires another method. After switching your project to DirectX 12, you can create a script and use this code. Here's how it works. The script will store the graphics estate collection into a file. First use Bing trace at the start, then spend time in your game, ensuring you run through every estate and shader in your level. Once done, press the H key to finish the trace and save the file to your project. As you can see, my graphic estate file has been created successfully. To use this file, go to your main script, comments out the shader variant collection and get a reference to the graphics estate collection. In the awake function, write this code to warm up the graphics estate in a multi-thread process. And that's it. That's everything about warming up shaders in Unity. If you want more tips, fixes, tutorials, or anything else about game development, make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching and have a great day.